What's good, my title making PD peeps? Thanks for watching this tutorial to learn how to create a cinematic title in PowerDirector 20. Cinematic titles add a crisp, clean, professional look to your videos. They set expectations for the quality of your content and communicate to your viewers exactly what it is they're about to see. Let's make something title-rific. I have a clip in a timeline of Day Moving Tonight. It's a time-lapse clip. If I play this back, you see the beauty and the revelry that is the beautiful time-lapse. Now, what I want to do is add a cinematic title to this. So, I'm going to start off by moving my playhead to the position where I want the title to begin. So I'm going to move about a second in here. Then I'm going to go up here to the title room. And I'm going to select the default title. I'm going to left click, hold down my left mouse button, and drag it down to track 2 where the playhead is. So you can make it whatever duration you want. I'm going to place my cursor here at the end. So I see these two arrows, hold down my left mouse button, and I'm going to drag it to the duration I want. Now, I'm going to go ahead and move my playhead back to the beginning. I'll double left click on this title, and it'll open the title designer. So for the title, I'm going to go ahead and left click in here, drag my left mouse over this, and type in the text that I want. Now, for the spacing, you make whatever spacing you want to make it fill out from left to right and space the letters how you want. For letter spacing, I'm gonna use 3 and hit enter. And now I'm gonna go down to the object settings section. And here I wanna go ahead and go down to add a position keyframe right at the beginning. And for this, I want my X position to be 0.5 and hit enter. And that centers it on the screen. Now my Y position, I wanna place it below the horizon where the water meets the land. So I want to go to 0.53 and hit enter. And that puts it right below that line between the water and the land because I want to make it look like it's coming out of the water. So now I want to move my playhead forward to about 1 second in. And this is where I want the motion to start going where the title comes up out of the water. So at this point, all I really need to do is add a keyframe, because I wanted to stay there at that same position between the first second here. And now I want to go ahead and move it forward about 2 more seconds to the point where I want it to be out of the water. And here I'll add another position keyframe. And I want to move this above that water line. So you can left click and drag it up there if you want to. What I'm going to do is go ahead, make sure my X is still at 5. And I'm going to change my Y position to a number that I'm already aware that I want it at. And hit enter. So now it's above that water line. So at this point, I want to move my playhead to a point where I want to fade the words off the screen. And here I'm going to add an opacity keyframe. And I'll leave it where it is. Then I'll move this forward to 8 seconds. And I'm going to change the opacity to 0. This will make it fade off of the screen. So if you go ahead and scrub the timeline, we'll see that it rises up over that line, and then it's going to fade off the screen. So now what I need to happen is I want to create a mask so that when it's below that water line, it's not going to be visible. When it goes above that water line, it will be visible. So to do that, we're going to scroll down to the title reveal mask section. I'm gonna left click this box to activate it. And so this dotted line is the mask. You can place your cursor here till you see this crosshairs, and you can drag it up or down, move it to wherever you want. But I already know exactly where I want it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and type it in. And for me, the Y position is -0.070. I'm gonna hit enter. And you see that dotted line goes right below the text. So that's where you want it because that's where it's going to be visible. Anything below that dotted line as far as the text is not going to be visible. So I can go ahead and click on OK. And now if I scrub the timeline, you'll see the text rises out of that water. All right, so now I want to create a reflection of the text. I could have just added a reflection, but it would have mirrored everything that was happening, and I want to have a separate effect happen with the reflection. So to do that, I'm going to go ahead and right-click on the title that I created, and I'm going to choose Copy. I'm going to click on Track 3, and I'm going to left-click, and I'm going to choose Paste. If it moves your title over, left click it and drag it back into place. So now I'm going to double click on the title that I added to track 3. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to reflection. I'm going to left click on that. And I'm going to change the distance to 1. And you can see it creates a reflection there. So now I'm going to go to the first position keyframe, and I'm going to right click it, and I'm going to choose duplicate next keyframe. The reason why I'm doing that is because I want the reflection to stay where it is for this first second. I don't want it to move at all. So now I'm going to move my playhead to 3 seconds, and I'm going to add an opacity keyframe here. And I'm going to change the opacity to 0 because I don't want to see it at this point. So now you can see that the reflection disappears. So I'll move my playhead forward to 4 seconds, about 1 second in. I'll add another opacity keyframe. And this time I will change the opacity to 100 because this is where I want the reflection to be visible. Then I'm going to move my playhead forward another second. I'm going to add a opacity keyframe here. I'm going to leave it like it is because I just want it to stay at 100 there. And then I'll move my playhead to 7 seconds. And I'm going to change the opacity here to 0. And that'll make the reflection fade off of the screen. So now I need to go ahead and create a title reveal mask at this point, but I need to change it so that instead of how it was before, where only everything above this will be seen, I want to make it so that only everything below the line will be seen, which will be just the reflection. So you can drag it and move it. I'm just going to go ahead and type in the parameter that I need and hit enter. And now we're good to go. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And if we go ahead and scrub the timeline, we'll see it rise out of the water. Then we'll see the reflection fade onto the screen. We'll see the reflection fade away. And then we see the words on top of the water fade away afterwards. So everything's looking pretty good so far, but I want to add a little bit of glizzo to the shizzo. So in order to do that, I'm going to go ahead and go up to the effect room. And where it says search the library, I'm going to type glow and hit enter. Now, if you have PowerDirector 365, you can use this BCC colorized glow. If you don't, you can just use a regular glow and change the parameters however you want. I'm going to use BCC colorized glow, so I'm going to left click it, hold down my left mouse button, and drag it down to the first title, the one that's above the water. Now I'm going to go ahead and click on effect. And for glow channel, I'm going to change this to alpha edges. Let me move my playhead forward so you can see what it looks like. It has a bit of saturation in here that I don't like, so I'm going to change that. You can change the settings however you want to make it look however you want. This is how I want it to look. What I also want to do is keyframe this so that the effect fades in. So I'm going to click on keyframe. And I'm going to move my playhead to 3 seconds. This is the point where the effect should be on the screen. And I'm going to go ahead and add a keyframe for every one of the different parameters. Then I'm going to move my playhead back to 1 second because this is when I want it to start bringing in the effect, like right when it starts coming out of the water. So I'm just gonna go ahead and add a keyframe here for each one of these. And as I add these keyframes, I'm gonna move these all down to zero. And because they're all at zero here, this is where they're gonna start moving up towards the other parameters at 3 seconds. So that'll make it look like they're all, like the glow is fading into the letters. And so now I'll go ahead and add keyframes here at the beginning so that it holds it at zero this whole time. So now we can close this out and we can play this back and see what it looks like. Cinematic fantastic. PowerDirector can make all kinds of cinematic titles for your videos. If you want to make cinematic opening credits, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.